time. I don't think these people on earth understand you at all, God. You created them, blessed them, and loved them. You gave them the beauty of creation, and they keep doing crazy things that hurt each other and themselves.
You gave them the Ten Commandments, 10 simple rules, and they can't even keep those. It's hopeless. They're never going to understand.
You used Moses and the prophets to lead them, and they rejected them. Maybe they're beyond help.
Look what they did to the prophets. I don't think they're to be trusted. They didn't listen. I don't think they'll even listen to your son. Remember what Isaiah said? All of us like sheep have strayed away. We have left God's path to follow our own.
If you send down your son, they might kill him.
They will. My beloved son will show them the way. For those who believe, they'll come home again.
Yeah, I'm not buying it. You're perfect and holy, loving, kind, full of grace and mercy, and they're just so...
evil? Even when they're trying to be good, they fail miserably.
Trust me.
Angels of God.
Good evening, sir.
Are your angels ready for your next assignment?
Yes, sir. Ready and willing.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Good. This next assignment I have is just right for you. I want you to find a young woman called Mary in Nazareth and tell her that she's about to become a mother.
That doesn't sound hard.
Yeah, it's going to be a little tricky. She isn't exactly Mary yet.
Wait a second.
And her boyfriend Joseph isn't really the father?
What?
Boy, that sure sounds like a hard assignment. Maybe I should go along and help her.
No, I think she'll do just fine. Besides, I need one of you to go visit her boyfriend Joseph and tell him the news. Lucky you.
Oh.
Thank you. All right, angels, you're on your way. Good luck.
Have faith.
Really? Me too.
Your son's life.
Joseph is good. He will protect home.
It'll be really hard for him. Your son may not even make it to be born. Mary and Joseph are young and poor. If he was born in a palace, Maybe. At least then he would have soldiers to protect him.
Pregnant? She's flipping pregnant? I certainly didn't have anything to do with it. Supposed to be gods? What the heck? What am I supposed to think? I mean, I have to break it off, right? That's like a death sentence. Could I live with myself? People are talking about us. She freaking betrayed me. So confused. I'm so tired of all this. Wake up. Maybe I'm not dreaming. Are you for real?
Whoa. Okay. Just a messenger. This is all taking place to fulfill what God has said. Mary will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel. It means God is with us.
Be brave. Okay. If this is God's plan, let's see.
Let's do it.
Wait.
What now? Come on, you don't need that.
Angels of Scott.
Good evening, sir.
New assignments.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
What is it you want us to do?
Okay, so. You're gonna go out into the fields and you're gonna find some shepherds. And they need sheep. You're gonna tell them about the baby's birth. Real fancy like.
Shepherds? Why them? Why not shopkeepers or tax people?
Angels, it's best not to question God. Shepherds are simple, hardworking people who have been waiting for this just as much as the other people you've mentioned. Now, get to work, angels.
Yes, sir. We're on our way.
Guide them. Found them!
What's going on? Are you trying to take away our sheep?
Maybe they're taking our jobs!
Oh no, you wouldn't do that. We're sent from God. Don't be afraid. We bring you the good news of a great joy that will be for everyone. Today, in the town of Bethlehem, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
I heard this would be happening. We're in Bethlehem.
Can we? But...
directions were not part of the mission.
Okay, I can only give you a clue. You'll find him wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. God says you won't have any trouble finding him. Glory to God
in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill to all.
God.
Hi, God.
Okay. Good job with the shepherds. They got a little turned around, but they made it. This time, you're going undercover.
Undercover?
Yes, you'll need to be a star. There's a team out looking for baby Jesus, and they need help. You, angels, will be the sign for them to follow. Do you think you can handle this?
Yes, sir. We're on our way.
Follow it. Angels.
ragtag volunteer bunch of poor, smelly shepherds. And those wise people, do you want us to proclaim to the kings and rulers of the world as well? I mean, at least warn them that they'd better look after your son.
Just watch.
It's going to be left to a bunch of scruffy and ordinary people to let the world know about your son?
That's the plan.
I gotta see this.
Right behind you.
Charlie's Angel script with a head lead solving problems. So maybe you got a taste of that with Boss Man there, Gibby, as a primo angel. So we appreciate the way that humor helps us to think of things, of a story that we've heard many times. And so, actually, Gibby, I'm going to have you give this. You spread that out across your chest. The right direction. Upside down. Our drama mom, I want to give it up for Emily and all of her. manages a million hotel groups as a full-time job, but she does it in her own office at home. So there's Monday's clean shirts if you haven't had time to do laundry. if you couldn't read it from the back, it says Drama Mama, and all the kids signed it. Emily, between Ben and Emily, they have 5 children, 12, 10, 4.5, 2.5, and 1. Did I get that right?
I'm sure.
One has a birthday coming up, so we're moving them all up shortly. And then another one. So we are very grateful for all the work and heart you put into this. And I'm going to say a little more about that in a second. But I know that you have found in each of them, some of them who have God's spiritual gifts of drama. And I'm grateful that you worked with all of us to make sure we all felt a place in there. I want to also thank Tim on the soundboard, who has spent hundreds of hours before today to make sure that we didn't have feedback. Some of you remember some days when we couldn't always hear, or we often had static competing. So thank you, Tim, because being a soundboard.
Woohoo!
Things don't go perfectly. No one notices when the dishes are actually done, the laundry's done, all those things. So we thank you, Tim, for that. Ruth, thank you for playing for us, and thank you for all the other musicians. Like Helen, who works around not only a symphony schedule, but around our schedule to give us space for the 2 hours before. I'm gonna excuse you.
Hey, let's thank the kids. Let's thank the kids.
Thank you, the kids, yes.
Whoa, yeah, awesome.